Pastor Will, if you were on the prayer call, he talked about being grateful, even for those things that we forgot that we were once grateful for. And so if the Bible says, if you be faithful over a few things, he will make you ruler over many. So again, go ahead and give God a hand clap of praise for gratefulness, honor, faith, peace, jobs, blessings, money, cash apps, relationships, children, health, marriages, strong marriages. Amen. There are people that are getting divorced every day, but I thank God that here at 3D Church, we have strong marriages and unity. Amen. To God be the glory. And if you did get divorced, thank God for keeping you even through the situation. Amen. Because everybody that's for you ain't for you. Amen. We'll go to the throne of grace. Father God, we thank you in the mighty name of Jesus. We thank you, Lord God, that you surrounded us here on tonight, Lord God, with your love, with your grace, Lord God. And we're just so grateful for who you are in our lives, Lord God. We thank you, Lord God, that you keep us even when we didn't want to be kept. We thank you, Lord God, for your continued grace and your shield of protection over us, Lord God. We ask you that you continue to walk with us. Continue to guide our path, Lord God. Continue to give us wisdom, Lord God. Give us the right words to say, Lord God. Guard our hearts, Lord God, and our minds, Lord God. Don't let us speak too soon, Lord God. We ask you even on tonight, Lord God, that there will be a word that will pierce into our hearts, Lord God, that will walk into our destiny, Lord God. We ask you right now in the mighty name of Jesus that you touch us in a mighty way, Lord God. Give us the strength, Lord God, to continue to do whatever it is that you called us to do, Lord God. Don't let us have a spirit of giving up, Lord God. Don't let us have a spirit of failure, Lord God. But give us the spirit of victory, Lord God. And triumph, Lord God, even when we grow weary, Lord God, that you will continue, Lord God, to build us up and give us, Lord God, everything that we need to do what you have called in our lives. Touch your people. Touch the word on tonight, Lord God. Touch Pastor Will on tonight as he give a dynamic word to your people, Lord God, as he teach us, Lord God, and we will be refueled on tonight, Lord God. We give you all the praise and all the glory. Touch our pastor, Lord God. Give him, Lord God, the strength, Lord God, to continue on doing the works of the Lord. And we love you, and we give you all the glory and all the praise here tonight. In Jesus' name, come on, somebody shout amen. Amen and amen. All right, let's give it up for Pastor Will Brown Jr.
This is my regular job, too. Watch this.
All right, bye-bye. I feel God responding to our corporate cry.
Praise God. How y'all doing tonight? Uh-oh. Praise God. How we doing tonight? Y'all got to talk back at me a little bit now. How was your day? Good, 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 good. So let us pray real quick. Father, right now in the name of Jesus, we come to you asking you to remove every little thing that could take us off of that mark of the attention that you're going to have. Right now, let you encamp and let you take over every obscure mind, thought, anything like that that's going to keep us away from getting the word that you have given to me to give to these people. Lord, decrease me and let you be increased in me. And in the mighty name of Jesus, we pray. Amen. All right. So, we have been, you can have a seat. Sorry about that. So, we've been having a series right now. Anybody can tell me what that series is? Say it a little louder. That's right, special characters. So have you really enjoyed it? I know I have.
Yeah.
I've loved it, loved it. So tonight, we're going to continue that. And the character we're going to talk about tonight is going to be the comma. The comma. Now, as you know, on Wednesdays, we don't do the traditional service kind of thing. So this is going to be an interactive exchange between myself and you all, right? So it's gonna. We need some talking back to me a little bit. All right, let's have a practice. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. There we go. Cool. So, when this special character kind of came to mind, as actually me and Pastor John was having a conversation about a few things, and that came to, you know, front of mind as what a comma is. Anybody know what a comma is? A pause? What else? What else does it do? I know we're not at school. Yeah, it can connect two sentences. And when you don't have a comma in a sentence, what can happen? It's a run on. Now, how many of you in your life right now know there's some things that you've been dealing with that you have not taken the time to pause? What has happened in the moments? I know for me, anytime I don't take the time and acknowledge God in whatever I'm doing before I go forth, there's calamity. So that's the importance of this pause. And anything that we do, we have to realize that how we start a thing is how we what? Finish a thing. So to tie that all together, me and my son, we were having a conversation the other morning. Somebody was on a prayer call, probably heard this kind of talk. But we were talking, and he wakes up. He doesn't like getting up early. I was telling him on the call, I was like, this grumpy. First thing he says was, my day is going to be terrible. They're going to get on my case. And I was like, son, you're starting your day off wrong. So what I told him, I said, son, every morning now, before we say anything else, you and I are going to get out of this bed, and we're going to pray and thank God for what we have. So in that moment, he was like, okay. So we did it for the first day yesterday, and even this morning. And today he came back and said, Dad, I had an awesome day. I said, look what happens when you start your day off the right way with God, with you saying thank you for what you already have. I said, look at that. That is amazing that you can put something out in the air and you get a return because you put it out the right way. So there's a Bible story that I was kind of going to, and if you have Bibles or Bible apps or anything like that, you can kind of go with me to this particular passage. Anybody familiar with the Promised Land story with Joshua? So essentially what happened is they were out in Egypt first. They were prisoners in Egypt. And then they were then taken through the wilderness for 40 years. That's a long time. We talked about how long that is of being a wanderer, being out in the wilderness, not knowing where you need to be. And this particular story and the excerpt for where we're going right now is actually Book of Joshua 6 chapter 10th verse. And once you have it, just say amen. I know y'all, if you don't have it, say, wait a minute. And if you're not looking for it, say, help me. Y'all going to have to wake up for me a little bit. Y'all a little too chill. Come on, talk back to me. Book of Joshua, 6th chapter, 10th verse. And 6th chapter, 10th verse. And I'll be reading from the King James version of it. And I'm going to go ahead and read it. And we got it back there. That's awesome. All right. So, and it says, I'm reading the King James version of it. And it says, and Joshua had commanded the people, saying, ye shall not shout, nor make any noise with your voice, neither shall any word proceed out of your mouth until the day I bid you shout. Then shall ye shout. So the big important piece of that was that as they were actually making rounds around that city that they were already promised that they were going to inhabit. Now, part of that is that if they weren't obedient in that moment to hear that call and say, hey, be quiet, don't say anything, what could have happened? There's a possibility that they were disobedient he was told not. They were told not to say anything, right? They would definitely could have alerted people they shouldn't have alerted. There's a time and place for that, and he was setting an order. So, how many of us have been given a vision by God and we talk too soon, or we share something that we shouldn't have said in certain confines of certain people, and now they become dream killers for us? Not that God can't do what he's going to do. God's what's going to be done regardless. But the point is, why have that have the extra adversity? There's no need for that. So we have to learn in that moment, the moment that we have to watch when we anything at all. Let God do the work and let it be manifested into your life. So right now, one of those points I would just say is like sometimes you got to keep your mouth closed. That'd be like if I had a point, that would be don't talk too much. Yeah. Catch the bubble. There you go. So in that moment, like you got to really think about that. Like think about like even for me, there's certain things that I know that I talked a little too quick on and I made my move known too quick. And sometimes what happened is that opportunity between when something's supposed to be happening, we're supposed to seize that opportunity in that window of time that's allotted for us, and we missed the opportunity because either we didn't move enough or we did too much. So my point is God is saying to everybody is that really pay attention to what that window of time is and be really on purpose about paying attention to hearing his voice when to speak. When you speak out that thing, and even in prayer, we get into a process where we always are asking for things and we're talking about, oh, I need this and oh, I need that. The gratitude is what? The seed for more. And the more we ask and say, not ask, but say thank you for something and put that in the atmosphere, start your day off right, acknowledging him, he will direct your path through all of that. Now you've now got around all of those things that you could have been having as obstacles because you chose not to talk too soon. Sometimes we create enemies for ourselves. We just do it. We just talk too much, and we create a situation that didn't even have to be there because we chose not to be obedient in that moment. And I know if you're like me, there's certain things that are awesome, and you're so happy about it because it's so great and something you've been praying for. And he knows the desires of your heart, and we know that. But in those moments, we just got to understand sometimes some things you got to keep to yourself until God manifests it to be an example so he gets the glory. And that's part of the problem. We want to say it too soon because we want the glory. We don't want to wait for that manifestation. We want to, it's a boastful, it's a pride thing. And in that moment, we have to really check our pride. Because yes, God is doing something amazing in your life. And yes, he needs to get the glory. But back in our mind, it's about us. And we have to check it. We have to be really, really careful. So say, check your mouth. Don't say a word. Just hush up, as they say in the world. Shut up. Just shut it up. All right, so in my little research, I was kind of looking at the ways you can use commas and things of that nature. So in all the other punctuations that we and characters we talked about, they have all these purposes. So there was a time back in, I'm going to say my age a little bit, 1996, where me and some family and friends were going to a club, a place called The Gate. Anybody from Decatur know about The Gate? That was the spot. Yeah. My wife just said, yeah. So this place, though, was really, really a good hangout for all teens and some young adults. People from that were popular would come out and perform. On this night, my family members from Carrollton was coming down to try to enjoy some time. My mother said to me, clear as day, I never forget it, I don't have a good feeling. Don't go. To this day, do not go. And we said, oh, no, it's going to be okay. My brother's coming with me. I know I don't do clubs because I was that peculiar child that just was different. I didn't hang out like that. I was always kind of to myself. But she said, okay, I'll let you go. My brother talked her into it. Literally, I did not make it to the club that evening because the enemy caused a young lady that was in her car fussing with her children to not pay attention and come out of a stop traffic lane and run head on into the vehicle that we were in. That was my comma. I'm going to tell you why, and this is a testimony because most people don't know this, and even my mom didn't even know this. I was dealing into some stuff that I shouldn't have been involved in with both cousins and other people around me just to kind of hang out and kind of fit in. Like, I was starting to smoke. I was doing, you know, illegal stuff that I shouldn't have been doing, hanging around people that were gang affiliated at that time, too. And that was God's wake-up call for me to say, hey, this could have been a headline. Young man in car dies. Period. But God saw fit to say, young man in accident, pause. God saves to be a minister and a pastor to his kingdom. That comma is that pause, that time for you to get it right. Because of the decisions that we made, and we choose to want to say, hey, we know it better than he does. Yes, he's the author and finisher of our faith. But we don't know more than he does. And we got to be able to be in that position where we trust him that much to where come what may, it's going to be all right. But because of that decision that I chose to make, it could have ended a lot different. But God saw fit to give me grace and mercy to get it right. And God has given everybody that same choice and opportunity every single day. There's things, and we get opportunities all the time that we could give God glory in a moment, but we don't do it. Because we're worried about being too churchy. Or we're going to be the peculiar person in the room and be the different person that's going to get talked about. But God made you who you are. You are to be the light in a dark place. And that's okay. Where I work at, when we walk in, myself and my other pastor friend here, we get ran over. Because people come to us because they know when we are there, we're going to give so much love and positivity in the room to whatever is going on in that place, it's going to evaporate. It's going to be a whole bunch of fun, and it's going to be the love of God in that place. We got people coming into this church, joining, that have never been in church almost all their lives or have turned away from church because they see how God can change lives. We are examples of what God can do. And you don't have to be perfect for God to be in your life. You just got to have a will to want to be used by him. So my question that I will leave with you today, essentially, I mean, really, do you want your life to end you want your life to be filled with commas or a period? It's a little deep. I need commas. There it is. There it is. Commas come in all forms, hey. So there's a couple of scriptures that I want to kind of leave with you too. That really, when I start doing this research, I was like, man, this is amazing. That God, even in his word, finds a way to make sure that you understand the importance of that pause and that time that you have the ability to make some things different. One of my favorites. It's a Romans Road to Salvation scripture for any of my MITs in here. Romans 6:23. That's one of my favorites. Anybody know what it is? For the wages of sin is death, comma. There you go. And it literally says, for the wages of sin is death, comma. Not period, comma. But the gift of God is eternal life in Christ Jesus, our Lord. Then there's another one, Matthew 19:26. It says, Jesus looked at them and said, with man, this is impossible. But with God, all things are possible. So even in that moment, like with things that you go through with your life today and going forward, that moment when you're thinking that you want to give up, that moment where you say it's just too tough, don't look at it like it's a period. It's an opportunity for you to acknowledge God and say, this is too much for me, and I need help. And God will grant you grace and mercy of a comma. And your story lives on. But how you start that thing is how you're going to end it. You start with gratitude, you're going to end with gratitude. You sow seeds of blessings, you reap blessings. And that's how that works. Just like Pastor John said, it's almost impossible, literally impossible to plant an apple seed and get a brick. Let's take it all with it and get a brick. What you sow, you will reap. And sometimes, again, we get impatient. We don't want to. We just give up too soon. There's some things, like even for me, like with my businesses and things that I have, I'm connected to. Had I given up too soon, I missed the harvest because I was impatient. Wow. Take the time to let God show you where that comma goes and when it's time to continue the sentence. Because without that, you're going to miss your blessing. And that's all I got for you tonight. What are you looking for God to do in your life tonight? Where do you see that you need God to throw a comma in your situation? Is it your marriage? Is it your relationship with your sibling? Is it your relationship with your children? What is it that you know that you need to take time to allow God to do his thing? And you get out of the way and let him help you finish writing that sentence. Just think about that real good, because God is going, he's never going to leave you. He's not going to leave you hanging where you're running in circles, thinking you're doing some things on your own, and you're just running yourself ragged because there's no end, there's no period in the end of it, but you just you're running away. You got to take the time to stop and pause, acknowledge him, pray for direction, and he will surely show up and answer your prayer. Y'all be blessed.
Come on, let's give God a hand clap of praise for the pause and pray. All right, Q&As. I was doing some research on pause, and in the book of Psalms, and ironically, I have been doing a study on it before now, because, of course, after on the seventh day, God did what? He rested. He paused. And in the book of Psalms, you see the word Selah a lot, S-E-L-A-H. And that's basically pause and pray. So a lot of times, you know, we take the pause, but what do we do in the midst of the pause? And I want to have this Q&A because a lot of times it's not that we don't know how to pause. It's the fact that we don't know what to do while we are pausing. Some of us get into conversations we shouldn't be in. Some of us do things or make decisions that we shouldn't be in. Some of us say some things or we start to think things that we shouldn't think about because we are pausing, but we're not praying in the midst of the pause. And so let's talk about it. What are some of the things that we should do when we take a break? That alone time, that all one time. What are some things that we can do when we do pause? Read your Bible. How many of us, with a show of hands, start your day off in the Word? Seriously, in the Word. Every morning when you wake up, you don't touch Facebook, Instagram, text message, but you say, I'm in the Word. Honestly, very few of us, and I'm one of them, and I'm the pastor here. I'm being honest. Why? Because special characters is teaching us all. Now, I do it maybe 3 times, 4 times out of the week. But most of the time, I'm running late. I hit snooze too many times because I'm pausing, y'all. Lady T know how to pause. I can hit the snooze all day long. You know, I pause when I take my break or when it's time for me to go on vacation. My problem's not pausing. Pastor, my problem not pausing. My problem is, what am I doing during the pause? Is it effective? Is it productive? What am I thinking during the pause? Am I in my word? What are some of the other things we could do during the pause? Meditate. Meditate on what? The word? What else? Y'all giving me all these cute answers. Reading the Bible, that's good. That's perfect. Meditating. Rest on what? What about write our visions? What about focus? What about read something that is going to help propel us to our next purpose that God has called us to? Like, Lady T will read her Bible, but then Lady T won't pick up a book to read about film or read about how to write or read about how to explore or get a thesaurus so that she can help with her vernacular. My problem is not the pause, y'all. My problem is, what am I doing with the pause? It says faith without works is dead. I have faith enough that God is going to do it. And like Pastor Will said, you know, we can start off our day saying a lot of things, but do we actually start our day off with saying, I can do this. I can do this through Christ who strengthens me? Do we start our day saying, I have a goal to reach? These are the things that I have allotted in my book and I'm checking them off. Yes, I read my word. Yes, I took a book out. Yes, I made sure I did the LLC. Yes, I made sure I at least bought the domain to the website. Yes, I did talk to this relationship. Yes, I did check off something on my credit. Yes, I did see how I can get approved for the house. Yes, we're believing God for all of these things and we have the pause, but we're not actually taking our work with our faith and putting it into action. Can somebody in here tell me on tonight that going forward that you will actually put your faith into action? You won't have another excuse. You won't say, I just can't because you didn't, but you would say, I just can't because I didn't do it because of my own self. The comma is very important. Selah says, pause and pray. We have to pray for these things. But if we don't allow God to work through it, and if we don't put the work with our faith, it's never going to happen. I am a highly productive person, and the people that I hate the most are lazy folks. Don't make excuses. Make it happen. Come on, let's give God a hand clap of praise. Any Q&As, because we're here to help. Q&As. If you feel like, you know, I can't make it. If you feel like, you know, I don't know what to do when I pause. Ask the question. We're here. How to be productive when you're in a depression. How to think positive when you're surrounded by calamity. You know, all of those things are very important. I was talking to a student today, and I said, hey, babe, you got to be in a positive space. She said, Ms. Elmore, I can't. She said, that sounds good. She was 13, having a breakdown. She said, that sounds good. It sounds good to say, wake up every day on the right side of the bed. That sounds really good, but it's even harder to practice. And I want us, I think Wednesday night Bible study refuel is to help us get on the right trajectory to think positive and to do positive and to understand how to pause and question marks and what to question and how to question and put periods at the end. Because some relationships just need a period, amen? That's the end. That's it. That's it, a dot. Period, poo, amen? All right, no questions tonight? Y'all got it all figured out? Really? How's life? Anybody wrote their visions? No? We did the vision board. Did you write your vision? Writing your vision is like this. I have, let's say, $30,000. You know that's your salary. What is allotted to tithes? What is allotted to bills? That's a part of your vision, too. What is allotted to savings? And then write down what you want to do. If it's a business, how are you going to get the business? Is it a 501c3? Is it an LLC? Is it what type? Is it a corporation or organization? But first, you got to do research. Like, we say we want these things, yet we don't take the step to do it. Pastor said something so amazing. One Sunday, he was preaching. He was saying, you know, we say we want to be a millionaire, yet we don't know what we would do if we get $1 million. Somebody on the stream sent him a message with all of the steps it would take because she heard it. She caught it. Didn't she? She sent him like a message and said, these are the steps I'm going to take. If I get $1 million, I'll have my money here, 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 here. And she wrote it all out. She went and did the research. A lot of times we say we want these things, but we don't actually do the research. So I'm going to challenge everyone here tonight, and remind me to challenge people on Sunday morning, to write your vision and make a checklist and a deadline. If you want to see yourself out of a job and you want to own your own business, have a deadline and then have realistic goals on how you're going to get to that deadline. That means I need to make a certain amount of money at a certain amount of time so that I can be able to be in a position where my income is coming from my business alone. We can say, oh, I just want to quit my job. But if we don't have a plan, that's not going to work. If we want to own a house, then we have to say, okay, I need to pay out, I need to pay up this much debt by this time for me to be able to be in the running to purchase a home. If it's a car, if you want to be debt-free, we have to write our visions. The word is clear. Write the vision. Make it plain so they that read it will run with it. A lot of times we think we're supposed to run with it, but it's not us. It's they that read it, like the creditors. Amen? Yes. Well, I'm not going to say you can't focus on two at the same time because Pastor said ministry and the marketplace. He's like, he is the guru of different things at the same time. So I'm not going to tell you that. Me personally, I have to focus on one thing and then jump to another. But I will say this, write out exactly what you want to see. If you want to see a food truck, start there. If that's what you want to see. If you feel like you want to build your clientele, then write that out and then see what that would take. If you build your clientele, you can just start with simply making orders, putting it out there and say, hey, this is the cake for the month or the pastry of the month or the bacon thing for the month, and then just take orders. That's my idea. Or consult. Meet with a business consultant or somebody or a branding consultant that can help you get your thoughts together so you're able to, like, understand what you want to do. Because sometimes we're creative, but you have to have three type of people around you. Creativity, administrative, and communicator. I am very creative. I lack in administrator. I could do a little bit in communication. I could do a little bit. So I have to keep people around me that are really heavy gifted in those two areas. You are the creator. So you would have to link yourself with someone that can help you communicate your thoughts. And that's how you start there. And just write it down. If you write it, Megan, I promise you, if you write it and you see it and it's in front of you every day, you're going to check it off. You can start first with just what is the name of your baking business? Right, so you just put a lot of stuff in a hat and then get your LLC. Get it, start there. Yes. It's right. If you work for yourself, you write that off as a business, but your business have to have a tax ID and EIN and all that stuff. If it's not, if you don't have that, you can write it off as a hobby and then still just write off the stuff you use to make your stuff, like gas and all that stuff. It's still a write-off, though. Yes. Mm-hmm. Megan. Mm-hmm. It could be Megan Pastries. A Meg. I don't know. I'm just Megatrees. Trees. I don't know. That's just me. Just start somewhere. And do it. Do it. Oh, you bought cake tonight? May the Lord watch between me and thee. I'm going down the steps. I'm going to get me some cake. I was just playing. But start there. But you have to decide that's what you want to do and write it down. Just like Pastor Will said, how you begin a thing is how you will end a thing. If you wake up every morning with that business on your mind, every morning, I promise you that will be the last thought. Even when you go to bed, you're going to have that pattern. You're going to create an awesome pattern that will help you propel to your purpose. I promise you. What's so funny? You're naming. It's a baby. It's like a baby. You don't just birth the baby and then just be like, baby. No, we're just saying it's the. Yeah, that's your baby. You're birthing a business. I was just giving the analogy of when a mother had when she birthed a child, she doesn't call it baby. I know. Sunshine cupcakes. Cravings. But Cravings Cater is really, that's really kind of catchy. Craved. I don't know. Don't get me going. We'll be all night trying to think of Megan's bakery. This is not that session, all right? But I get it. So your homework, write it down. Write it down. Write it down. Who did that? Craze Craving Cakes. Cakes Craving by Megan. Craving Cakes. But I'm creative, though. I could do that all day. I am one of those people. Like, when they need something, they'd be like, Lady T. Nope. I did that. Oh, my God. My phone was blowing up all day. I had a creative social media day when I say, if you have any ideas, text me. And that was all day. I had to. I like that. What did I say? Craving Cakes. Ooh, that's good. Ooh, that's a good name. Craving Cakes. I need 6%. I just went. All right. Any other questions? Anything else? That's it. All right, come on, let's give God a hand clap of praise for amazing vision. That was the reason why you was here tonight, amen? Come on, let's celebrate God for new vision. Man, to God be the glory. Let's give Pastor Will a hand for delivering a great message on today and thanking God that some of our situations are a comma and not a period, amen? To God be the glory, I'm just so grateful. He said something tonight, shut your mouth, shush it up, catch a bubble. It was so funny. A lot of people said, I never knew you were building a studio. We've been doing this for 12 years. But we didn't share it with everyone. Because believe it or not, everyone is not for you. Some people will pray against your blessings. They will. They will see you doing something, or they'll try to do it just because you're doing it and it's not their grace. And so they just try to take the spunk out of what you're doing, and that's not their grace. So sometimes you have to move in silence, not just for them, but so that you won't talk your own self out of your own blessing. Because sharing it, you'll share it so many times, it becomes old to you. You said, man, I've been doing this for a long time. No, not really. An overnight success take how many years, Pastor? 15? So we are an overnight success. 15 years. Stick with it. Please. Stick to a witness. That's Pastor's word. Stick with it. Megan. Craze Cakes. What is it? Craze Cakes. Stick with it. Stick with it. Even when it gets hard, stick with it. Like, we had, mama over here, she had like 8 businesses. I can't even tell you. She do taxes, sell cars, she got a daycare. She would never know. Y'all would never know she have that many businesses. She works no job. Please raise your hand so everybody can see. Go ahead. If you want to learn how to start a business, she is the one to talk to. I've never seen her clock in since she been here at 3D Church. Have you? No, not one job. She creates so many different businesses and just as humble as she wants to be. If you want some information, she'll tell you how to get it. But that's because she didn't give up on anything. She say, Lady T, I think I'm about to start another business. I'll be like, go ahead, girl. Just go ahead. Whatever you put your hands on, it prosper. And it's not easy, but stick with it. Write your vision. All right, to God be the glory. Father God, we thank you, Lord, for the amazing word that came on tonight. We ask you, Lord God, that you continue to be in the midst of your people on tonight and that you continue to give us wisdom and grace in Jesus' name. All right, it's giving time at 3D Church. All right, if you need an offer envelope, raise your hand. Shamika, she's ready. She'll be ready. I think she come in with that stuff. Did you take it home? I mean, you're so diligent and consistent. I appreciate it. If you would like to give by text, you can give any amount to 678-203-9932, or you can simply cash out any amount to the cash sign, the 3D Church. Amen. Let's give it up for our media director, Joe, in the building. He popped up at my school today with all of his Clark Atlanta paraphernalia on. That was like, who is this? He looks pretty prestige. That's my media director. He was like, hey, how you doing? Yes, with Lady T. He made me look official. Then he just started to become my bodyguard all of a sudden. Like, who is this? I'm like, Joe, this is my school? Like, they know me. Like, that's my principal, Joe. Oh, okay. Like, she can hug me. This is her school. Like, this is hers. This is her situation. Amen. So just thank God for awesome relationships. Did everyone have the opportunity to give? We will have media rehearsal starting in 5 minutes with our media director, Joe. So if you would like to stay for that, you are more than welcome to learn more about the media department here at 3D Church. All right, everyone prepared your gifts. Hold them up nice and high. We're believing God for businesses and better businesses, jobs and better jobs, raises and bonuses, sales and commissions, perks and benefits, favorable settlements, unexpected checks to the mail, unexpected cash apps, whoop whoop, gifts and surprises, debts paid off, expenses decrease, and blessings increase in Jesus' name. Go forth with your giving. Amen. To God be the glory.
Hey, if you're watching us online right now and you just made a decision, whether it was salvation, rededication, or even if you just became a member of our church, listen, we want to stay connected to you. So do us a favor. Write us a message in our inbox at the 3D Church or simply leave a comment in the comment section below. And listen, congratulations. You just made the best decision of your life. God bless you.
Also, there will be a dance ministry mandatory meeting on Saturday at 12 p.m. So please make sure you are in attendance for that. Our free family movie night is February 21st. We will be showing the movie Shazam. So please make sure it's free. Bring your family. We're going to have an awesome time in the Lord as we watch Shazam. I didn't see it, so it'll be my first time seeing it. So invite your friends, your family, and your cousins, your aunties, your uncles, and all that stuff out. Our Heritage Black Excellence Sunday is February 16th, so you can wear all of your nice African dashikis and all of that stuff like that. We are celebrating Black excellence. Amen. Also, all my divas, make some noise. Divas Women Life Group, we will have, drum roll please, on February 28th, we will have our karaoke night potluck with our divas. So please, please invite the ladies out. We're going to have some fun. Oh, there will be door prizes and prizes and prizes for those that can karaoke. Why y'all looking at me like that? Y'all don't like karaoke? You like karaoke? Oh, it's about to be on like popcorn. So I cannot wait. I don't know what the men are going to do, but the ladies are going to sing and eat and get our Beyonce on. Thank you. Thank you. All right. To God be the glory. Is there any other announcements I'm missing at this time? All right. Awesome. All right. Everybody had the opportunity to give. Father God, we thank you, Lord. Okay. Father God, we thank you, Lord God, for this offering. We thank you, Lord God, for this seed. We ask you, Lord God, that you bless it. In the mighty name of Jesus, we give you all the praise and all the glory in Jesus' name. Amen. All right. Hug somebody on your left and on your right and tell them, put a comma in it. Put a comma in it. Comma, comma, comma. Take a pause, Selah.